Hello everyone. Here we want to introduce you the MCDM XL, which is stand for Multi-Criteria Decision Making, or sometimes saying MADM, which is stand for Multi-Alternative Decision Making, which will help you for decision making process. Before we start, we should note that if you open this Excel file for the first time, you have to enable the content of this Excel file. This is because this Excel is developed based on macros and VBA language. It's warning you that right now it's disabled as shown. So you should enable the content of this file to enable the macros. Okay. Here we can see there is two tables here. The first table, you have to introduce your criteria. For example, if you want to buy house, you have some criteria for your house. For example, the price of house, where is the location of that house, and everything else. Some criteria might be negative, some are positive. For example, the price of house is negative, location might be positive, and for example the how much big the house is, the bigger is better, so it might be positive one. After that, you have to get some weight for each criteria. For example, which one of these criteria are important, more important than the others. And it should be noted the summation of all criteria should be 1. Here you can add some criteria, for example, C6. If it's negative, you can say it's negative. And you have to get the weight of the criteria here as well. You have to enter it. So if I change some of them, because it's have to be 1, the summation of all criteria must be 1. So here we have 91, and it should be 0.09, I guess. And if you see here, yeah, it's all 1. After defining the criteria matrix, we have to define the decision matrix here. In the decision matrix, we have each alternatives in the first column, and each alternative should be in each row. For example, R1, A2, and A3 are three different alternatives. For example, if I want to buy house, it's A1 house, which is for example its location in street 1 and so on. For example, I want to add another alternative, A4, which is the, for example, house in the 4th street. If you here for example, you have to add the value for each alternative in each criteria. For example, for a C1, A8 has 1.2 and A3 is 1.5. It's a negative criteria, so if it's bigger, it's worse for us. For example, if I put 4 here, it means that A4 is more bad than A1, if you view that in the C1 criteria. For example, in here, C4, if it stands for the price, it should be negative. Price is negative for buying the house. If it's $24,000, it's much better than the $32,000. And if it's be a $100,000, it's worse than all of them. If I want to buy the house A4, with the price of $100,000, and it's need much bigger wallet for that. So you have to enter all the values for the criterias, and for example, I put the 4 here and 2 here and 1. I don't know what criteria might be. For example, it might be a price, it might be a how much big the house is and how much it is beautiful. What about the garden? If it has a garden, it can be a 0 or 1. It has garden or it has not the garden. How much the garden is beautiful? How much tree is there? All of them might be the criteria for you. So after you define the decision matrix, you can come here and choose your method. For example, if you choose SAW, analyze cannot be processed. Okay, why the analyze cannot be processed? It's show me some error because I have C4 here. It's another criteria, so I have to add it. You have to be noticed that if you define a criteria here, you have to define it here as well. So these two should be same as together. And if it's the first one is C1, the first one here should be C1 as well. C2 here, C2 here, all the way to the C6. So I've defined the C6 as well here. And I have to, it's negative. If it's bigger, for example, I want it 2, this one 10, it can be 5 and 4. These values should be entered based on your calculation for each value for each alternative. For example, if it can be for a house, it can be the criteria of the garden, how much the garden or something else. For example, the kitchen, how much the kitchen is, well, it can be the positive right now if it's a kitchen. So I came here and 10 is the best kitchen I have right now, and it's A1 has the best kitchen. But here A4, which have a lot of money price, but it has a worse kitchen here. Okay, after you define the decision matrix, you can hear, and now if you press SAW, it's handled with the SAW, which is here. It say you have to buy A1, and A3 is the worst of your decisions. So the house which is located in the street 1 is the best decision you can have. You can use another methods here. VIKOR, ELECTRE, and TOPSIS and SAW are the most famous methods in the decision matrix, decision making process. So if I choose the VIKOR, it asks for me the VIKOR strategic weight. Most of the time it's 0.5, and if you press OK, it's done, and you have the same result. A1 is the best and A3 is the worst of them. But in the more complicated problems, it might be have a different solution between the VIKOR and SAW and others. So we can use TOPSIS and we can use ELECTRE as well. All of these methods have some algorithms which is developed in a VBA. If you go to the developer tab, you can go to the Visual Basic and you can see all the algorithms here for ELECTRE, for SAW, for TOPSIS. This Excel file has any password. and you can simply go and edit whatever you want, and you also can add other methods by yourself if you want to. So this Excel file is good for learning VBA as well. So you can go and see how I code the algorithm there and how it's functioned, and you can learn it and use it for yourself as well. Thank you for listening to me. I wish this Excel file help you a lot.